दिस इज जनत अली कमाल और आप देख रहे हैं हिंदुस्तान. एज हिंदुस्तान इज रीलिंग टुवर्ड्स जनरल इलेक्शंस, मेनी क्वेश्चंस आर बीइंग रेज्ड ऑन गवर्नेंस और लैक ऑफ इट, देयरफॉर एंड द वे द सोशल नेटवर्क्स आर बिकमिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंटल इन पब्लिक लाइफ. We today have with us Shweeta Punj, who is a journalist, a TV host and a social entrepreneur. She is a senior editor at India Today and she has worked for more than a decade in Hindustan. Thank you so much, Shweeta, for joining us. हमारे साथ कॉल पे मौजूद है मिस श्वेता पुंज, हु इज अ जर्नलिस्ट, अ टीवी होस्ट एंड अ सोशल एंटरप्रेन्योर. शी इज अ सीनियर एडिटर इंडिया टुडे. थैंक यू सो मच मिस श्वेता फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस. सो श्वेता, इलेक्शन कैंपेन इज थ्रोइंग अप मेनी इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू गवर्नेंस, स्पेशली ऑन द सोशल साइड. डू यू थिंक इट विल बिकम ऑल राइट?
Yeah, so of course, this time in India, elections have taken a huge new dimension, which is the perception management, especially on social media, considering India's digital penetration has really increased at a phenomenal pace. So a lot of first-time voters, a lot of influencers, they're all using social media to build opinions, to build perception. And political parties are completely tapping into this, whether it's Twitter, whether it's Facebook. In fact, in the government, all the ministers in India, they all have social media accounts. I'm sure you must have seen our External Affairs Minister, Ms. Sushma Swaraji, has been prolific in using Twitter as a very, a very productive tool of governance. She's used it to reach out to Indians abroad. She's used it to help out Indians stuck or, you know, in distress situations across the world. And in the run-up to elections, I only see this battle in social media intensifying. Of course, another consequence of this has been proliferation of fake news. A lot of videos that end up going viral that tend to create a lot of, sometimes stress and tension in the system. So Indian media is also coming to terms with this new animal called fake news, which is again a fallout of extensive use of social media.
So Shweta, you have established a think tank and a feedback mechanism. So do you think that social media and social sciences have their importance?
Yes, absolutely. I think social media is very important, and it's something that no individual or no political party or no country for that matter can ignore. If it has to be a vibrant democracy, you have to be open to feedback, you have to be open to two-way communication, and I think somewhere social media has enabled that two-way communication. Earlier, lawmakers and parliamentarians were on a pedestal, were on a platform, and they had to rely on a group of people to get feedback from their constituents. But now what's happening is that people in India are logging on to social media to give feedback, to interact with their parliamentarians, which I think is phenomenal. And we've seen this change in the last 8 years, because when we started Vipol, let me tell you, 90% of the parliamentarians in India did not even have an email ID that they were using. And from then to now, I think it's been a phenomenal journey where Indians have adapted technology very effectively, where in fact even our Prime Minister has used technology to ensure that that benefits get transferred to the right people, that there is no pilferage in between. He's used it to seek feedback, not only in governance, but within the political party. The largest opposition party in India, the Congress party, has done this. When recently, when elections were held across states, across the three big states, a lot of candidates that were vetted according to the feedback that was given on an app which the Congress party had designed, and which enabled a lot of party workers to give their feedback on different candidates. So I think it's been, technology has its perils, but it also has its benefits. And India is embracing technology with full gusto, with full enthusiasm. And we're also putting together a privacy bill in place so that we know that, data should not be misused or manhandled. So there are a lot of things at play here. And I think it's an interesting chapter that India is that an interesting chapter which is turning for India when it comes to campaigning, when it comes to governance, when it comes to democracy.
Okay, Shweta, we'll continue to know about Hindustan's social media. We'll take a short break here. So, Shweta, before going to the break, we were talking about social media. So, is social media setting an agenda for the masses?
Yes, I would think that it is setting an agenda for a certain constituency, the urban constituency, where people are logged on to social media. They're more influenced by what they see and what they hear, what they read on social media. So that's where I think the agenda is being set. In fact, a lot of pertinent questions are being raised on social media first before they make it to television debates. But in rural India, it's a different story. I think rural India, the issues are far more localized. And that's what even the politicians are. They do their research before they go and campaign in rural areas. But when it comes to setting the agenda on a national platform, on national channels, social media is playing a huge role. In fact, whether it's what's happening right now with Rafael or a lot of the big issues, they'll be first flagged off on social media before they make it to the debate, the primetime debate in the evening.
So, Shweta, like you just said, that social media is playing a huge role. So, are actually the things going wrong, or the media, especially the social media, is creating a hype?
I wouldn't say that social media is creating a hype, but there is a if you are not on social media, I think you tend to feel calmer and you tend to feel a little more optimistic about the world. Social media has its perils as well, and it's being used by political parties to attack each other a lot, and a lot of times, like I said, a lot of false information is put out and it tends to go viral, and that causes a huge damage. So you need to have your checks and balances in place. You need to have better accountability. You need to have maybe some sort of regulation to control, what goes viral, or to control content which can be inflammatory or it can have dire consequences. So that is there. But I think social media is also being used as a tool to raise important issues. There are always two sides to a coin. So yes, it is sometimes creating a lot of negativity, but I think it's also being used to hold a lot of people accountable. It's being used to raise very relevant issues. It's being used for two-way communication. So I would look at it both ways.
So Shweta, obviously that the political parties built a narrative to grab power through votes and media. It is a conduit. So do you think that media should behave in a more responsible manner?
I think Indian media behaves in a very responsible manner, and we have a very robust media in India, where we have over about 200 to 300 publications in the country. And I think we have the Editors Guild, we have the National Broadcasting Association. So we have like a regulator in place. And I would think that the media is also reinventing itself, because we have to understand the way people are consuming news is changing drastically. Though in India people are still reading newspapers, but then a lot of the young Indians are relying heavily on the mobile. They're looking at short videos. So media is doing all of that as well, and there's this deluge of information out there, which needs to be processed and put out very quickly. So there are mistakes that the Indian media ends up making, but there is recognition of the fact that, we have to be careful. Is the most credible and one of the oldest media houses in the country. And let me tell you that we have lots of checks and balances in place to make sure that whatever we put out is extremely objective. It's not furthering an agenda. It is always vetted it's as accurate as it can be. So we've set a standard of journalism for ourselves, and we have put in processes and systems in place which enable us to follow that standard of journalism. And I would think that a lot of the big media houses in the country are also trying to do the same thing. So the media is very cognizant of the fact that we have this entire universe out there which is constantly flooded with information, with news, and we have to do something so that our viewers and our readers get the most objective information so that they can form their own opinions. And there is this entire perception that there's government interference and all of that. In my 18 years in journalism in India and abroad, I've worked in the United States as well. Let me tell you, I have never been put in a position where I have felt compromised, and I think I'm speaking on behalf of my colleagues here. The government enables the media in every possible way.
Okay, Shweeta, we'll continue to talk about the media of Hindustan. We'll take a short break here. Shweeta, do you think that social media is replacing the mainstream media?
No, I don't think so at all. I think social media and traditional media are coexisting and very happily so. And I don't think social media can replace traditional media, at least for the next 10 to 15 years. After that, we can't say. But yes, Twitter, Facebook, they're being used as aggregators of news. But having said that, what's happening, that's the feedback that I've been getting, is that even your social media feeds are manipulated with the algorithms that they use. So very often you'll end up seeing the same feed, right? But I think with traditional media and mainstream media, there is the sense of objectivity that you have. There is the sense that, okay, I've subscribed to this magazine or I've subscribed to this newspaper, and you know that they will bring you news and analysis the way they have brought it. So it's far more detailed, far more thorough. There is something for everyone, even if, there are political biases, they're not as apparent. And, newspapers and magazines ensure that there is something for everyone, to give a complete perspective to the reader, which I don't think that the social media is able to do at this point. Maybe going forward, depending on how news habits of people change and evolve, we could look at that scenario. But at this point, I would think that the traditional media is strong and growing. In fact, India Today's magazine's readership has only gone up. We are seeing new newspapers being launched every second, third day. We are also seeing news portals coming up. And so that would have me believe that there is a market out there. And, there is always a market for objective news.
So Shweta, where do you see Hindustan's mainstream media in 2025?
So I think that the media industry is going to go through a reinvention phase where we will be a lot more prominent on mobile platforms. We have already tapped into the digital space. We will experiment with new ways of presenting news and information. I think magazines and newspapers will have to focus a lot more on content. I think content is going to be key, and content is going to be because Indian readers and Indian viewers are becoming more discerning. They want, they want objective news, and they want to be able to sound more informed. They want to know what's happening in the country. And I also think that that the news and information will move away, to a degree from the kind of political news reporting we do. It'll also be, we've seen platforms like, we've seen a lot of positive news platforms emerge. And I think that's probably going to also, I think at the end of the day, people want motivation, people want hope, people want inspiration, people want news. And I would think that the Indian media would grow into tapping into all of those constituencies as well. And of course, we'll see a lot of creative disruption as well. We'll see a lot of, new startups. We've already seen startups coming up, and we'll see them growing into, setting like a new template for how news should be presented.
Okay, thank you so much, Shweta, for joining us. Thank you. Thank you for watching Hindustan. Till next episode, goodbye.